Hi everybody, I'm Corinne Blackstone and welcome to my computer. Today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about the difference between Weld and Unite within Cricut Design Space. Before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here, that way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content. But I do find that this is a concept that can be a little bit confusing for everybody because they basically do the same function, but they do the same function in a different way. So we're going to go over that today with you to help you understand when to use Weld, when to Unite, and what the difference is between the two. So without further ado, let's get started. We're going to begin this tutorial just using two shapes, and it really doesn't matter what shapes I'm using for this, but I'm just going to open up and use two separate shapes. Now, I have a star and a heart, and I will make these two different colors just so that we can see a lot better what we're doing. And I'm going to make them larger as well, just so you guys get a really good view. So you can see we have these two separate shapes, and they are two separate layers over in our layers panel. Now, let's say we want a heart, but we want it to have like a sharp, stabby thing coming out of the side, and we want it to all cut as one piece. There are two different options that you can use to create this shape and create it together. What you'll need to do is select both of your layers, and you can go down under this combine option down here. And under combine, we have two options that will work for what we want them to do. One is the unite option and one is weld. Now, if you hold it over, it does tell you a little bit about it. And weld merges two or more separate shapes into a new single shape. Keeping in mind that you can do this with text, images, just about anything you can use. And then under unite, it says that combines two or more objects together into one new object. Each new layer appears as a new editable layer, which I know can be a little bit confusing. So let's use unite first. Now you'll see under unite that you have this little arrow here. If we click that down arrow, you'll see that you have both of your layers listed here and we can actually adjust them individually. So if I want to make like the star bigger and I want to make the heart smaller and I click away, you'll see that they are still united because there's no cut line between the two images, but I'm still able to edit them individually. The other thing that is nice with Unite is you're able to undo Unite even after you save a project. But Unite basically just removes any cut lines between overlapping shapes or text. So let's say I want to undo it. I just go under my combine and I click undo Unite here at the bottom. And I'm going to make our star a little bit smaller again. And now I want to talk about Weld. So Weld is your second option for removing cut lines between images. Also, how can you tell if there's cut lines? Do you see this black line that goes over the heart? That's gonna cut, and if you don't want it to do that, you just use Unite or Weld. But we're gonna use Weld on this one, and I'll show you what Weld does, and I want you to kind of keep an eye on the layers as well. If I go down to Combine and I click on Weld, you'll notice that now we only have one layer here. We can't go individually and change any of the shapes of our layers. Now also, if I were to save this and exit out of my program, I can't undo this if I want to change anything, add anything, or take anything away. I can't do that with the Weld option. Now if I haven't saved yet, I can undo until my Weld is gone, and you'll see now that I'm able to move these apart. Now again, you can use this with multiple layers and multiple images. So let me just grab, let me add some text. I'm just gonna leave it as text because it doesn't really matter what this says, but I wanna show you that when I use Unite and I use Weld, I can use it with multiple things, which includes text, it includes offsets, images, anything on your screen, you can use both of these options. So you'll see here that we have the three different colors and these are our three different layers. If I select all my layers and I go down to combine and I unite them, you're gonna see that now everything turns red and all of those cut lines in between all of our images are gone. So that's what Unite does, is it basically like glues them together. Think of it, the way I describe it is, think of it like Play-Doh. If you take two pieces of Play-Doh and you squish them together and you flatten them, or even like regular cookie dough, you can't get them apart exactly again. That's going to remove any of the lines that would be in between that dough, so it's going to make it all one piece. But But again, remember, with Unite, I'm able to edit the different layers. So I'm able to take the text and make it smaller. And then if I click away, you'll notice that the text is now smaller and everything is there. Now, if I want to undo this again, I just go to Undo, Unite here at the bottom. And again, I can edit these different layers to whatever I want them to be. I'm going to go ahead and just change their colors really quick so you can, again, see this a little bit easier with our weld. So now, again, you'll see all the places where the different colors overlap would be cut lines and would cut into each of those images. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the entire design and I'm going to go to Combine and Weld. And you'll see now, again, we only have this one single layer, and then we have our pieces here, but we can't individually do them. And if we save it and close our project, we can't undo. Now, another thing I want to show you, because I do think that this is part of understanding cut lines, I'm going to attach these really quick. That way you can really see where those cut lines would be. Now, attach is great if you want to hold pieces in place on your mat, but you still want them to cut out of the different pieces. So you'll see here, like where the X is, it'll cut this out of the star. And then it's going to cut this little edge of the T out. It's going to cut this out of the star here. And then you're going to have a part of the heart that's going to be cut out with both the star and the T. That's where attach would come into play, and I'll link down below a video where I talk about attach and group and when to use those. But this one here is going to show you all about weld and unite. So honestly, I use weld a lot if I'm going to never change the design and if I only want it to have one layer, because maybe it's a lot of layers. Maybe we've got like 47 different things. I'm just going to add a bunch of shapes here and just show you kind of what I mean. It doesn't matter what shapes I'm using. I'm just going to throw a bunch of stuff here at the screen. So now you'll see that I've got all these different shapes and layers, and I'm just going to kind of set them wherever on the screen, because again, it doesn't really matter what our design looks like. But you can see here that I've got all these layers, and there's just a lot. And let's say I know for a fact, you know what, I'm never ever going to want to change this. This is not a design I'm going to use again. I don't need to change anything on it. So for something like this where it has a lot of layers, I do tend to like to use Combine and Weld. But if you want to use Unite, you can also use that as well. And you'll see again that you're offered the option to change up those layers. You can see each of your layers individually. But if I would rather, and I don't want to change anything and I want to use Weld, you'll see now that it just shows one single layer as Weld result. And you can always change the name of your layers. So we're just going to call this Weld Test. And you can change that so you kind of know what it is. But that way is just, there's two different options and you want to use the one that's going to work best for whatever you're doing with your design. So if you're going to want to undo it someday, maybe you need to change it up. Maybe you need to change how it's laid out. Maybe you need to change a word on it. Use Unite, because then you're able to undo it and you're able to then cut it without any of those cut lines. Now I will show you really quick just so you can see. So right now, if I have it set the way I have it, and I will go ahead, I'm going to attach it. And then I'm going to make it a little bit smaller just so it fits on the mat. And I'm going to click make. I don't want to save this. I want to show you what it looks like on the mat just so you can get a better idea. So if I've attached it, you'll see that it all holds in place and you can see where it's going to cut. It's going to cut all the black lines. So it's going to cut out pieces and parts of the design. Now let's detach it. And I just want to show you what it looks like if you detach it, and it's going to have everything spread out around your mat so that it can cut all the pieces individually, but it doesn't hold them in place the way you have them. Now, again, I've explained that over in the group and attach video, which is linked down below. Now I want to hold this all in place. I don't want those cut lines. I'm going to go ahead and go to combine. I'm going to unite them. And now when I click make, you'll see that it's holding them all in place, but all those little black cut lines are gone. So it's going to cut just around the outside edge. And then any of like these interior pieces, it's going to cut those out as well. That way it's a little bit, you know, easier. You're not going to have all the cut lines if you don't want them. It's going to cut it all as one piece. And if that's the way you want your design to be cut, then you want to use Unite or Weld. So Unite or Weld basically removes any cut lines between overlapping objects. I hope that makes sense, and I hope that you've picked up some tips and tricks. Now remember, Unite can be undone even after you've saved a project, where Weld is a permanent choice. So I would use them sparingly depending on how you want to do your project. But I can definitely say I have welded some things and regretted it later. So I do think that Unite is a wonderful option. Remember also with Unite, you do have the option to work with the different layers if you want to change sizing on anything. If you want to edit the text, you want to change the font on it. You're able to do that by using the Unite option versus using the Weld option. So there's a lot of different things that you can do with this that are going to make it a lot easier for you to work with your project. And like I said, Unite you can undo, Weld you can't. So just remember that when you're choosing. Now, if you have any questions about this or anything else that we do on this channel, please let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure you're subscribed here. That way you don't miss out on any of the great DIY content we have coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting!